Welcome to Jacksonville, Florida, and the annual site of one of the best rivalries in the sport. Not a lot of distance between the Gators and the Dogs, and once a year they come here close to the state line and draw their own battle lines. Little gets the blood boiling, quite like a rivalry game. Barbs, shots, trash talk, things that go on throughout the week will now all be settled on this field. As we'll see a team coming off a crucial bye week, the Florida Gators, taking on the number one team in the land, the Georgia Bulldogs. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. The Gators will get us underway with the opening kickoff. The ball bounces through the end zone, and it will be a touchback. So the Georgia Bulldogs offense will get the first possession of the game. This nasty, bitter feud, most of the years carried out on supposedly neutral ground, carries high, high stakes today, guys.
I'll tell you what's always fun about watching this game between Florida and Georgia is that there is just so much speed on the field. I felt that way when I played in this game. There's so much NFL talent racing around. The game just moves faster than most other games in college football.
I completely agree, but you did say the name of the game wrong. It's the Georgia.
And he's got it at the 20. Touchdown, Dogs! And once he found some daylight, it was time to make a house call.
Man, you want to make a statement early in a game. Your first offensive possession, you go 75 yards for the touchdown. Their opponent right now is literally in shock and awe. They're in disbelief. They don't even know what hit them.
Ready to try the point after. And he's got the extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. That kind of drive will boost your confidence. One play, hit the big pass, put a touchdown on the board. They're just about ready to kick it away. And it'll be a touchback. The ball will come out to the 25-yard line. So the Florida Gators offense will try to get something going with their first possession. You know, yards figure to be hard to come by through the air, but some quarterbacks, Jesse, just love to go at the star corner.
Yeah, and this guy's got confidence. He's not afraid to go at anybody, but he better be careful because this cornerback is one of the best in the nation.
One of the best, no doubt. I think they will trust him on defense to make plays. So you got to make a decision. Is my guy good enough to beat him on the outside? I am fascinated by this matchup.
Both of you guys played in this rivalry. Jesse, what's your most impactful memory?
My senior year, first and one on the goal line, and the Bulldogs had Marcus Stroud and Richard Seymour, two first-round picks at D-tackle. Coach Spurrier called Red Snoopy, which was a quarterback sneak. I didn't get it. I called it again on second down. I didn't get it. Called it again on third down. I didn't get it. On fourth down, he subbed our running back, who came in the huddle and says, "Red Snoopy, jump over the top, idiot." And we scored a touchdown.
That is great. That is phenomenal.
Back to pass. It's Mertz. Fires into traffic. Intercepted. Not much of a chance on the return, but they'll have the ball at the 33.
I love when people start to understand what we're doing defensively. If they're going to pass the football and that's where they're going to live, well, I'm going to live and die. I'm going to bring more defensive backs on the field so I can cover more of these speed guys that they have out there. Great job on the defensive back, breaking on the football, making the INT, making the DC look very smart.
And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. They torched this defense with an explosive passing play for a score last time out. Let's see if they go right back at him. They've really performed at an elite level in conference play, and that'll build your confidence as we continue through this SEC season.
This was a team that was really motivated in the offseason coming into this one, and they knew the challenge ahead of them, but they also know how talented they are. And David, they're putting that on display each and every week here in SEC play.
And let's pump the brakes, because if they're happy with what they've done so far, they're going to have some losses. Like, this is a tough league. The SEC is not easy to navigate. They're going to have to continue to grow and get better, but it's a heck of a start.
Snap's going to come from the 23 on 1st and 10. Quarterback checking the play. He wants to throw. Fires into traffic, picked off. And after the interception and the turnover, this defense has set its offense up for business.
QB never saw the defender. He's staring his receiver down, telegraphing his throw, and the DB jumped all over that.
The give to the back. Breaks the tackle. And he fights his way forward, gets away from one, but not much doing on that one. These two first met back in 1915, and for much of their histories, they've been sleeping giants. But man, when they wake up, do they wake up?
Well, two programs, obviously, with a lot of history and a lot of great players in the past, but I feel like because of the recent success of both Georgia and Florida in the last couple of decades, this is a game every year that everybody, not just in the SEC, but I think around the country, have circled because of what this game means.
Well, and it's so cool when you're a fan and you play in this game, like me and Jesse both have. You can go back to a singular moment, like Run, Lindsey, Run in 1980, which was a 3rd and long on their own 7 that they converted Georgia to go on to win a national title. Big games decided by big moments that live forever.
The Gators decide to punt it away. They'll have to punt for the first time this afternoon. Found a little running room on that one. Picked up some nice blocks before he's run out of bounds. We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. After that last pick, David, they really need to take care of the ball this time.
No doubt. And Palmer, I want to know what Spurrier said to you on the sideline after a pick.
Do that again, and you'll be right here beside me for the rest of the game.
And a big play on the outside. What a job to keep those feet in bounds and get the completion.
On defense, I got to find a way to get some more pressure on the quarterback or disrupt their timing and their rhythm. I can't give them these big chunk plays through the air. I got to be maybe a little bit more aggressive or do something a little bit different.
They get him stopped after he pick up a 5 to the 28. Last time these two met, the big dogs 8 as Georgia rolled easily.
And taking care of business in a rivalry game like they did, it means a lot. The bragging rights are even better. I can talk about stomping you out. Speaking of stomp, 2007, Mark Richt getting the team to run on the field, celebrate. Those are the moments that you think about in this series that mean so much.
Yeah, we talked to the Gator coaching staff. They said it felt like Herschel Walker was back toting the rock for the Bulldogs. I mean, they had no answer for Georgia's running game a season ago. Defensively, the Gators know they've got to be a lot more physical in this one.
Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a 2nd and long coming. The run up the middle, looking for the score. Relentless, tough running gets it down to the 4.
All right, so now you're in this 3rd down situation close to the goal line, and it just feels, David, like they're going to have to throw the football in order to score a touchdown here. I like maybe trying to get the quarterback outside on the perimeter and give him a run pass option.
I like that, too. Get the quarterback on the move, and here's the thing. If I get close and I get stopped, it's 4th down. 4th down means go for it. That's all that means now today in college football.
It is true as he puts 3 on the board. And now the lead is extended a little further. So after putting 3 on the board, the kickoff team is out there ready to boot it away. And they desperately wanted to attempt a return, but decided not to. Instead, they'll take the touchback. Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. Last time, David, it was 1-2-3 kick.
The last drive, that three and out, sometimes that puts your defense in a bad spot, and you got to get a drive together here so you don't wear the defense out.
I just think, David, too predictable that last drive. They got to do something here to get this defense on the field.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's second and three. The pull and throw off the RPO. And it's a first down. They'll mark it at the 44.
And a big key on that throw to the slot receiver, guys, is putting the ball out in front. The location of the throw is what helped that guy get extra yards after the catch.
They'll give it to the back. Didn't get much done on that run. He'll fight his way out and maybe pick up a yard. They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. To the air, it's Mertz. He's right on target. And he's able to shed one tackle, but still, just a very short gain.
So it's third long, and this quarterback right now has got to be expecting pressure. So you want to know where your hot routes are. You got to know where your best one-on-one matchup is. But understand this, we're still in the first half. If the defense gets you, tip of the cap, you can take a sack. Punting the football at this stage of the game is okay.
And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down. And the Gators will bring the punt team onto the field. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. A fairly short distance here toward the sidelines, not his best work. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. They had to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse. They'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here, Dave.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
They'll try again on second down after the incompletion. Now the play fake. Going up top. And he hauls it in inside the 30. And they pick up a better than 30 yards on that completion before the defense brings him down.
That's a beautiful pass and catch. I love the job the quarterback does manipulating the defense with his eyes. He froze that safety, and that allowed his receiver more room to work his route.
And off to Jones. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
I'll be honest, that is a formation and a play call I was never expecting to see in this game. This offense is one of the top 10 passing units in the entire country. I'm surprised they even have goal line in their playbook. What are we doing?
Fires to the wideout. Got his man. So close to that end zone. He can almost taste it, but it'll be first and goal for this offense. Have a day. We're in the first quarter, and already he's over 100 yards receiving.
This is ridiculous. Obviously, this coaching staff, baby.
And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Georgia! They've got the lead and trying to put this one in a hammerlock here in week 10.
This running back was not going to be denied. Nice blocking up front to create a hole for this running back, and he was able to take advantage.
Lining up for the PAT. And with the extra point, they now have a 3-possession lead at 17. A very efficient 5-play scoring drive. And they finish it off with a short plunge into the end zone. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. Fielded in the end zone. It's Abrams. I imagine he's going to get an earful on the sideline after bringing it out of the end zone and being knocked down at the 11. Plenty of time for one more snap before the end of the quarter. Looking for a man. It's Mertz. Throws to the wideout. And that's going to be knocked away and incomplete as time has expired here in the first quarter. Well, guys, it's Georgia holding the lead at the end of the quarter. Really strong performance so far to be able to build a lead here in the first period as we look at the stats. Now, the challenge here. Punch, but they can't let it get out of hand as we start the second. We'll start the quarter offense about to snap it on second down. Out of the gun, the inside give. Just what the doctor ordered to get away from the shadow of that goalpost to pick up a first down at the 23.
This guy's got a lot of tools in his toolbox toting the rock, man. He showed you right there. And when I think back to Florida running backs, Emmitt Smith, all-time great. But a guy I played with in Gainesville, Fred Taylor. He was so big, but so fast for a guy his size. It just caused so many problems for the defenses we faced. And I think in the SEC today, you have got to be able to run the football if you're going to win games. And this guy right here, he's going to give the Gators a chance.
Tackle is made at the 28 after a pickup of three. Here they come, trying to convert a third and short from the 28. From the gun, wants to pass. The throw to the outside is complete. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
Well, look, that wasn't a touchdown. That was a massive play for this offense. They needed some momentum. They needed to find a rhythm, and what better way than converting on third down? Awesome job by the quarterback getting through his progression.
Nice, solid form tackle from this sophomore.
And sticking to the run. I tell you what, a lot of teams that are really good are really stubborn, and they continue to run the football even with little success. So this offense is going to continue to focus on running the football, you can tell.
He's got his man. And they'll bring him down, but not before he picks up the first down.
I think really good wide receivers do a good job of making every route kind of look the same. You could tell, this looked like a vertical route. So if I'm a DB, I'm bailing, and all of a sudden, he sits that hitch down. Nice job by the wide receiver, creating enough separation to create a positive game.
Got three on first down at second and seven. The handoff to Johnson. Got enough for the first. Bulldozes his way through. And he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Gators!
And I am a great play caller when I can hand it to guys like that. And he can go that far to the house, create big plays, showed you a little bit of vision, showed you a little bit of burners, and he kicked it in gear. He got the long touchdown.
About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the five. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. Now they need to put something together to answer that last score.
There's a lot of pressure, too, on this offense to have to execute at a high level. They've got to score points, David, but they can't go too fast because their defense right now is tied.
And I think that's the difficulty being a play caller. Like, I have to balance all of those things. My defense is a little bit tired. I can't get on the field, but I got to be aggressive because this is a back-and-forth type game, so a lot to process and think about.
The receivers often will run their route based on a side adjustment. Throws to the tight end. Makes the grab. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense. This offense lines up feeling awfully good after that big play. He'll come out throwing on first down. Blasted as he lets it go. Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance. Now on second down after the incompletion. They'll leave it with him. They ripped off seven on that one. Now a third down and three.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting on this block, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
And he goes. goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there.
Defenses throughout the week study every third down situation. You got to be ready for what they do, how they do it, and then be able to adjust. Great job by the offense so far having success.
Off the play fake on first down to throw. Time to take a shot. Picked off. Takes it the other way. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception.
This is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. Two interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision.
The running back has it. And I think they'll give him two on that one. Second and eight coming up. Tried to pound it on first down. Now back to the line. Back to throw. It's Mertz. Firing to the right, complete. And that play just never got started as he's run out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage. They'll come to the line at the 42, facing a third and long. From the gun, wants to pass. Catch in the middle, it's Wilson. And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop. The Gators will try to pin them back with the punt.
A nice job by the QB there, timing out that drag throw. It's zone coverage, so he's got to make sure he gets it to his receiver in a window to allow him to catch the ball and then turn it upfield.
Just a wall of defenders everywhere he looks, and he's guided out of bounds after a short return. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. That last drive was promising for a while, but you just can't mess it up at the end with the pick, Jesse.
No, you've got to be able to finish drives, especially in this game, if you're going to win. And David, they've got to be able to eliminate the mental mistakes.
Yeah, and I don't think you get conservative or play it safe. You can trust your guy.
And that is interception number three on the day. Touchdown, Florida! The defense puts six on the board with a big-time interception return. The DB saw it. He thought, don't drop it, don't drop it. Then thought, don't get caught. And he didn't. The pick six.
Hey, these guys can play offense, too. Now, look at this. I show you I can be a wide receiver. Coach might split him out at wide receiver next week after making that big play. But defense, great job making the interception. And you're right, doing something with it. Don't just slide down. Don't be content. Take that thing all the way back.
We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. The big thing now, don't get rattled by that last pick six, David.
Nah, it was a big mistake. Obviously, the defense took advantage of it, but you got to put it behind you. Jesse, I'm sure you know a thing or two about throwing a pick six and how to rebound.
I believe I've only thrown one in my life, but yes, I do, because of that singular instance. I'll say this. You can't let that play beat you twice. You got to go out and try to get it all back here in one play. Just execute the offense.
That's the way to open a drive. Now they'll put it in play just shy of midfield. He's got it on the right. They make the stop, but this passing game does some damage, and they move the sticks with the first down. This offense absolutely humming as they come to the line again. Running to the left. Just a solid stop by this sophomore.
And those physical runs take a toll. It might not be a big game now, but down the road, third, fourth quarter, late in the ball games, they tend to turn into bigger runs.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need eight on second down. Pulls it and fires to the left. And he'll step out of bounds after a very productive play.
My old coach said to never go broke taking a profit. Take what's there, take the positive yards, and never complain.
This third down play more than manageable from the 24. Can the defense stand tall? Back to pass. It's Beck. It's complete. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage before he was stopped, but using the running back in the short passing game gives him a first down. Third and short, and I guess the only thing they really took out of play in the shotgun was the quarterback sneak.
Yeah, and that's kind of what I like to do, Reese. I mean, third and inches, I want to run the quarterback sneak, run the football, but this team fully comfortable throwing the football, and you see why. Easy pitch, easy catch, first down.
The magic bean is spinning out of control. Already over 200 yards in the first half.
Yeah, they're being aggressive offensively, throwing the football, trying to take advantage of this defense on the back end. They've got their quarterback right now in the roof.
And they try the middle of this defense, and that is not happening.
You know, there are a lot of offenses that would decide to just try to plow that football forward in between the tackles. There they went with the jet sweep, trying to catch the defense off guard with their speed, but the defense was having none of it.
A run up the middle is stopped for no gain.
And you know exactly what time it is when you get down here in the red zone. You got to be able to run the football. But when you got a back like this who punches the ball in the end zone consistently almost every single game, you are going to feed that animal the rock.
Needs to get it in the end zone on third and goal. Touchdown, Bulldogs! And they take it in for 6 more points. A methodical drive that they finish off by tossing it to the tight end.
And the tight end, I tell you what, this is a position that's evolved so much, right? And you see him move all over the field. It's kind of like, where is Waldo? You got to find this big fella, especially down in the red zone area. This is the guy they're going to target and make the big play, get the touchdown.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And with the extra point, they're now up by a touchdown and a field goal at 10. And for a quick update, let's go to Kevin Connors in the studio.
Dynamite matchup this week, fellas. Let's show you what's going down. Eastern Michigan is in the unusual position of having to come from behind right now, but there's not a soul who doesn't believe they can't pull this off. They're trailing by 12 to Toledo. We'll circle back. If anything big happens, you should know about it.
Oh, and how about that? I know Kevin and those guys will be keeping an eye on it for us. Dropping back, it's Mertz. Safe completion on the screen. Hard running there. And he'll run across the sidelines after the good game. Looking at a second and short now. Wants to go up top. Fires to the middle. He's got it. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. Now they'll try to cash in this drive. First and 10 from the 50. Unloads to the wide. Fires into traffic. It's picked off. And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception. That's why you love veterans in this defense. They stay locked in on their rules, and he made the pick. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. And with the ball in a spot like this, David, they might try to get something on the board before the break.
Oh, great opportunity to be aggressive. Find those couple plays you like. Push the ball down the field. At least try to get a field goal here.
That's it, David. Just a couple of first downs here could be enough to steal 3 points before this half is over.
The offense quickly calls timeout to stop the clock. From the 25-yard line, it's first and 10. Wide receiver coming across in motion. To the air on first down. Caught in the backfield. It's Humphreys. And he broke one tackle on the way to a solid pickup there. The offense will stop the clock and use one of its timeouts. Running out of time here in the first half, they're going to have to be efficient to put some points on the board before the break. He's looking to throw. Fires to the right. Touchdown, Dogs! And they'll put that scoreboard operator to work and put 6 on the board.
Well, this offense is top 10 in the country in points per game because they've got a lot of speed and they've got home run hitters. They score fast. They don't need 10 plays to go down the field. You saw it right there. They've recruited well. They've got playmakers. They're going to be a problem for defenses all year long.
Lining up to add another. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. Quick strike offense on that 3-play scoring drive. And the finisher, an 18-yard touchdown throw. The kickoff team is on the field. They'll try to drive this one deep. And no chance at a return here. They'll start this drive at their own 25. Only 7 seconds remaining in the first half. Let's see how they play it here on first and 10. Leaves it with the back. Nice, solid form tackle from this sophomore. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Thanks so much, guys. And I need not tell you, rivalry games always bring out a ton of emotion. And no surprise, we saw just that in the first half today. And we have to start this halftime breakdown by addressing the play of this elite wide receiver. This is clearly a young man who, once he's finished playing on Saturdays, he's going to be playing on Sundays. The kid has different gears. He has a knack for finding gaps in the defense. And I can't remember a college player with that kind of catch radius. With that, let's throw it back to the guys to see how the fight between Florida and Georgia plays out.
Ready to get things going here in the second half as Georgia about to kick it away. He thought about bringing that out for a half second, but he'll take a knee and they'll bring it to the 25. The Gators sending the offense back to work. When you're facing a deficit like this one to start the second half, you really can't afford to waste a single possession.
Fresh start here in the second half. That's the only way you can look at this if you're on offense. Things did not go your way there in the first half. It starts with one play. To get our confidence going, we just got to get something going early here on this drive.
One play, stay aggressive. Now I think I can be even more aggressive on fourth downs because obviously I've built a deficit. My defense has got...
Look at that toughness just running through everybody. Got a lot of running room. Touchdown, Gator! He would not be denied.
Man, this guy is such a weapon because he's so dangerous. If he gets into the second level, great vision, and then David shows you the speed.
Just straight wheels, erasing angles. A lot of times when you're chasing guys that are so fast like this, you're like, I got him. No, I do not. What a big, long touchdown run. Pad those stats, young fella.
Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16.
Yeah, and he's been throwing it all over the yard, and he's now over 300 yards on the day. So, been a successful day. Now, 300 yards, I don't know, Palmer, 300 nowadays, that's like what back in the day for you?
That would have been 500. I would have won the Heisman, maybe. It's a big deal today in college football, no doubt. Listen, he's in a rhythm right now. He's in a groove. We've seen good decision-making. He's been playing on time, and he's been deadly accurate throwing it. Guess what? This game is far from over.
Man, a lot of times when you blitz that linebacker, it's about timing. You don't show your hand, and he gets up to the line of scrimmage, gets right through the line, makes the tackle for a loss.
And as soon as the running back gets the football, he's got a face full of linebacker.
Not much you can do there. Like, you got to have a little better block. You got to identify that blitz a little bit fast.
And the ball is caught. He's inside the 35. And he slipped through the crowd, and he'll house it. Touchdown, Georgia! Now they've got a little breathing room. They are in firm control of this game, guys, but you never want to let up in a rivalry game.
Because it only takes one play. We know how much of a factor momentum can be in these types of rivalry games, David, so this game's still far from over.
And this is where my leadership and my experience comes into play. When you got guys that have been through these fires, been through these rivalry games, you know the swings happen quick. Now you got to swing it back your way.
And it's no good. He missed the extra point.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker. Defense.
So the decision has been made, and the coach will take the penalty. Getting set for the point after. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. This offense prides itself on going after you, and they did with that long touchdown pass to finish off a two-play drive. The kickoff team out there and ready to go. And he'll just take a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. Trailing now by 17, David, this is an opportunity that they need to answer.
And down by 17, it's not panic mode yet. Like, I know we just gave up some points and our defense hasn't played great. I think this offense can still be who they are and stay consistent.
No doubt, lots of football to go. But you do get the feeling this is the time of game where, you know, it could get bad. If you don't score and all of a sudden they get the ball back, they take it down the field and put some points up, this thing might be over. So absolutely, this quarterback, he wants to drive this offense down the field and at least put something up.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. Single back formation, and they give it to him.
He may get more.
They make the tackle at the 33, but he's ripped off 15 yards and picked up a first down. He's over 150 yards on the ground. Powerful running from him, and the Gators have a long list of guys who've done that, led by the great Emmitt Smith.
An unbelievable list. And you can go Ernest Graham. You can go Fred Taylor. You can go back as far as you want. Guys, you gave them the ball, great things happen. They can run you over. They can run around you. So they're going to continue to feature this guy because he's a lot like those greats.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. Wants to throw. It's Mertz. Got his man on the right. Put it right on him. Sweet play. Good pickup. And they'll move the chains with the first down. The Gators come to the line with a new set of downs. To the ground with the back. He pushes his way down to the 4 as they get closer. And
keep pounding away at this defense and make them play the run. If you can get this many a chunk, they're going to have to commit more guys to the box, more guys to the run. Then you open it up for the passing.
They'll give it to Johnson. And he'll take it in. Touchdown, Florida!
And he's in for his third rushing touchdown. You college fantasy football players, that is what you want to see. +6, +6, +6. Let's go.
Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown.
38.
He'll take the return and try to improve the field position. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. Things have been clicking along nicely, Jesse, but they have to make sure they keep it up.
Yeah, they got to wake up. It seems like they've been a bit lackadaisical here the last few drives, maybe, as we've seen this lead dwindle a little bit, David. So they need a bit of a spark here to get that mojo back.
Yeah, and you always have the adjustments, and then your opponent adjusts, and now they got to readjust now because this game's getting a little bit tighter than they liked.
Well, on offense, no doubt, right? You've had success. You're throwing some tutties. Why not keep throwing it? They're going to keep being aggressive. You're going to have to do a better job, though, keeping this quarterback standing up.
Stacked up after gaining a couple to the 23.
I never know if it's grammatically correct to say a team is being out-physical. You hear it a lot in football, though. That's happening in this game. They are just not getting the push they need all game long up front to have any success when they decide to run.
Now facing a third and long. Looking downfield, it's Beck. He finds his man. Good job running that route to get past the sticks because he got nothing after the catch. They've got a first and 10 at the 34. They'll try it over the left side. Got the first down and more. They get him down at the 49, but not before he picks up 15.
Every offense wants to be able to run the ball and be physical, especially on first down. And you want to create second and short, third and short, or just get first downs like that run right there.
Quarterback will audible. Off the play fake on first down, wants to throw. Dances away from the heat. Excellent coverage and good use of the hands to knock it away.
Well, I know that one fell incomplete, but what a day this guy has had throwing the football. Multiple touchdowns, and he's done a really nice job with his decision-making. Hasn't thrown any picks, which has really helped keep this offense on schedule.
Able to pick his way forward for a decent game before the defense gets him down.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
How bold will they be on third down after that last run?
2-9 Philly.
Off the play fake. grabbed in the backfield. It's Etienne. He gets it oh so close to the first down marker, but I think he's going to be a touch short.
All right, they get the completion. Don't get the first down. So we've got a massive decision now, fourth and inches. Personally, I like QB sneak. I think that picks it up right here. No matter where you are in the field, you can keep this drive going.
The Dogs are stopped, but not before getting it past the sticks. They'll put it in play from the 40 on first and 10. Looking for a man. It's Beck. Unleashes one deep. And good coverage and better hands by the defender to knock it down in the end zone.
Ball hasn't hit the ground a lot for this QB. He's already thrown four TD passes. He saw a look, wanted to take another shot, and that time they just fall short with the incompletion. But this defense, they have not had the answer with respect to defending the pass in this game.
Quickly complete. Didn't pick up a lot there. Moved it forward just a few.
And a really nice job by the wide receiver. You run a drag route, find space. They're in zone coverage. They're not covering man-to-man. Find a little hole. Look at that QB. Y'all get on the same page. You could tell they were, and that's why they got the first down.
Good timing on the quick out. They make the stop, but not before they do their work up top and pick up a first down. And thank goodness for those new-age throwing techniques. It takes wear and tear off your arm because it ought to be tired by now over 450.
This guy can throw from all the different arm slots and arm angles he wants, Reese, but the end result is always the same. Completions and touchdowns. This dude's a machine.
And these RPOs always put the defense in a bind. But listen, you give up the run, they get a short little game, no harm, no foul.
Dialing up a second down pass play. That's reeled in, it's dealt. And a good job of coverage by that defense, just a short pickup. Long drive continues as the offense keeps working the ball down the field. Well, guys, it's Georgia holding the lead at the end of the quarter. And as we switch ends of the field, let's take a quick look at the national rankings. When you're dealing with a deficit like this, it's all about somebody stepping up to make a play, and you might as well start here in the fourth quarter. A third down try for the offense. Receivers telling the quarterback what they see. To throw, it's Beck. He can't make the catch, had it right in his hands, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, on third and short in field goal range, they dial up the pass play. Quarterback was trying to get through his progressions. There was just simply nobody open. Couldn't make an accurate enough throw. All falls incomplete. Now setting up a big decision here on fourth down.
On fourth down, looking to pass. It's incomplete, but here comes the flag, and I think it's going to be a first down.
And the defender just way too handsy on that last play. You could see all the contact as the ball was in the air. He simply can't do it, and the referee's caught it.
And the Bulldogs trying to get a touchdown on first and goal. Slams ahead. Touchdown, Bulldogs! And they add 6 more to the board with that trip to the house. They give themselves a little more cushion as they try to reel off their fourth straight win. There is little the Dogs enjoy more than sticking it to the Gators, and boy, are they doing it right now.
Yeah, taking care of business. And listen, Georgia prides itself on being a physical unit. Every year, they're going to just pound you and bludgeon you, and Florida has had no response, just like in the last several games in this series. Georgia's just, they got the upper hand.
Georgia's always had talented teams. Certainly that they were very talented back in the day when I played them. The program was in a great place. But because of recent success, they're just at a different level. What they're recruiting, what the expectations are, and they're really showing that here in the second half.
And it'll come out to the 25. No attempt at a return. The Gators sending the offense back to work. They'll put this one in play. First snap of the drive from the 25. They'll start this drive with a pass. grabbed over the middle. It's Hansen. And he laid the lumber to stop him from getting the first down. Picked up some yardage with that completion. Now second down. Off play action. Right down the middle. And he is finding wide open defenders all over the field. His third interception of the day. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
And as a defensive lineman late in the game, man, when you know it's passed, you're pinning your ears back, trying to get to the quarterback. And DBs are trying to do this. Pad them stats and get the INT. Nice job by this dude.
First down for this offense. The give out of the gun. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made.
Well, no mystery on that play call, right? You got the lead late in the game. You've gotten the ball back on the other side of the 50 on your opponent's side, and so you're just going to run it. And it's fine if they know that. You just want to stay on the field and bleed this clock. And you got to start thinking about where are your best runner runs. Which side of this offensive line is the strongest? Which guys defensively do you want to attack so you can take as much time off the clock as possible?
Already well within field goal range. Wonder how aggressive they'll be on third and long from the 22. To the air, it's Beck. Pressure coming. And the quarterback bought some time, but not enough. Down he goes with the sack. They're happy enough to try to take the points as the field goal unit heads out. And this kicker might be feeling it. He made one earlier, now from 49 yards out. Tried to give it enough body English, but he missed it. So guys, a missed opportunity to expand the lead. It's still a 17-point cushion. Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. Mistakes are going to happen, as they did on that last drive. Now, how will they respond, Jesse?
And this is the kind of guy who's going to take full accountability. That was my bad. That's on me. I'm about to lead this offense now down the field to score some points.
Dang, Palmer. I wish I would have played with you. I didn't play with many quarterbacks that were just like, yeah, my bad. Hey, guys, I got this. Sorry about that. It was more, you should have ran a better route.
Right back up top on second and 10. Another interception. That's his fourth of the day. Trying to take it back. And he will roll into the end zone. Touchdown, Dogs! With that last score, things comfortable here in the fourth as they are headed to a 7-1 record.
And that just might do it. Man, offense needed points badly. Defense comes up with the big interception, takes it all the way back just to pad their lead a little bit and make this game almost, almost out of reach.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. The kick is up and good and put one more on the lead. Let's go to the studio now and check in with Kevin Connors. Kevin, what do you got?
Terrific showdown this week, guys. Let's take a look at what's going on. Oklahoma State is just boat racing them right now, thanks to an offense that's putting up video game numbers. They're up 14 over Arizona State. For now, it's back to you, fellas. But, of course, if anything changes, we'll see it right here.
Thanks for the update on that one, Kevin. Let us know when it goes final. The Gators sending the offense back to work. Well, the good news is they threw a touchdown pass last time. It was just to the wrong team, Jesse.
Well, that's an unfortunate part of the game for quarterbacks. But guess what? They do happen. So you've got to be able to turn the page here and lead this offense.
Well, I think you know this defense is going to be aggressive. They're going to jump routes. They're going to play aggressive. You've got to take advantage of that. Maybe use that this time to your advantage.
On the run, it's Mertz. Going over the top. And it's incomplete, going for the massive explosive play instead. They're looking at a third down.
And this guy has been so important to this defense, the way he plays on the back end. Top 10 in the nation in interceptions. He just has a feel and reads the quarterback's eyes. He almost picked that last one.
grab near the marker. It's Badger. So important to convert these third downs, and they get it done. They'll have it at the 42.
Well, we know this guy is special, and because of that, his quarterback is looking to him on critical.
Oh, look out on the right. Slippery slide. Find his way and ran away from the crowd into the end zone. Touchdown, Gator. They'll line up to go for two. That had touchdown written all over it from the moment he caught the ball. Big play, big run for the score.
Yeah, it had touchdown written all over it because nobody was covering it. It would be a good idea to get a hand on him. You know, listen, I know the guy's got some speed, and maybe you give him a cushion and give him some space, but that was a little aggressive on the space department.
If they're going to pull off this big rally, they'll need to get this one back. They line up for the onside kick. Few anxious moments there, but the hands team, true to its name, as they make the grab and get the ball. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. Looking for a productive play on first down. The quarterback reacting to what the D is showing. Wants to throw on first down off the play fake. Got out of trouble, got rid of it. Not the type of accuracy you typically see from this senior quarterback. They'll line up for a second down play. After the incompletion, they go back up top. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
This defense knew they had a tall task playing against this Heisman caliber quarterback. And the best way to affect him is with pressure. They were able to hit him on that play, and that forced the incompletion.
Oh, look out! And it is a chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end.
Well, the defense didn't blitz. They didn't have everybody in gaps, and the offensive line took advantage at the point of attack, getting some push, opening up a hole, and the offense ripping off a nice run there.
And the defense holds firm. No pickup at all on that play. Defense rolls up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. Scanning the field. It's back. It's complete. And they get him down.
And I love when my quarterback sees zone and knows exactly where to go with the football. Sees the wide receiver running the drag route, knows when to throw it, pulls the trigger for the easy completion.
Trying to pound it in. Touchdown, Georgia! And the stomping has commenced. Starting to see some smiles on that sideline as they're close to a Week 10 victory. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And they closed the deal, pushing their way inches into the end zone. And they thought about a return, then thought better of it. They'll bring it out to the 25. Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. Line gets set, first down. He wastes no time and comes out throwing. Finds a man on the right. And they'll get it to the 39-yard line, and they'll move the chains. And the Gators want to move quickly.
And you've seen these curl routes. This is a timing route. Understand the ball's got to come out of my hand right when he hits the top of that curl. Nice job by the QB finding them. Nice catch.
They make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit at a time to get to that first down marker. And here comes the offense on second down. He's looking to throw. Good job to toss that ball out of bounds and avoid the loss.
And this is just one of those days, man, where everything has gone wrong, right? Like, they just haven't been in a rhythm. They haven't got it going and never built the momentum. This is one of those days that you learn from, you try to grow from. A lot of things that we're going to...
And that makes five interceptions in this one. The nightmare is alive. And a big return after the INT sets up the offense for this possession.
Heat up them pass rushers, bring in them DBs. That's what I'm doing in this situation. When I got the lead by a couple scores late in the ballgame, in the fourth quarter, I'm going to rush the passer like crazy. I'm going to put all those DBs back playing the pass. That's what happened. Great job understanding they're going to have to take shots. We get the interception. This one's almost over.
We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. And now one of the most satisfying moments in football, just watching that clock drain away while you have control of the ball, Jesse.
And this is definitely one of the best play callers, right, for an offensive coordinator. You're getting ready to go into victory formation. So many good things happened today. It seemed like everything he was dialing today, David, ended up working out.
No doubt. They put a lot of highlights together, put a great offensive game together, complete football game. They get the win. On to next week.
Puts him in the spin cycle. Big play for this offense as they get it to the 32.
Yeah, this offense has had their way with this defense, and they've had a lot of success. And I tell you what, if this defense wants any chance of coming back, they better get physical and stop the run, because right now, this offense is having their way.
Great team defense on that one. Everybody doing their job. People winning their one-on-ones. D linemen staying in their gaps. Linebackers and DBs filling. You just can't do it better.
To the air. It's Beck. Got his man on the right. And he'll go out of bounds. And this aerial attack just continues to carve this defense into tiny slices. Georgia coming out with a fresh set of downs. Quarterback checking off. Off the play fake on first down to throw. And this sophomore able to wreak some havoc and get the sack.
That's a play the defense needed, right? It's been a battle all game long. Here we are. It's late. Everybody's tired. They've given up a few yards on this drive, but they come away with a huge sack at a big moment.
And the defense makes the stop after a minimal gain.
And I'm a fan of this, man. Run the football, eat the clock. We got the lead. This offense has put together a nice day, man. Like, just balance, rhythm, timing, play calling, everything has worked. That's why they've built this lead. They've had a great day today.
And sure, tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker. So you might expect to see victory formation. Instead, you will see a field goal attempt. Didn't make him sweat at all. It's good. And they'll push that lead out a little further. That last field goal was a big one. Now it takes a touchdown to beat them. You want to pin them back on the kickoff here. And it'll be a touchback. The ball will come out to the 25-yard line. The Gators sending the offense back to work. This has been a really disappointing performance, David. No question about that. But they can find some positives.
Yeah, and every time you watch the tape, you know, Jesse, coaches are pointing out, look at this. This was open if we'd have just ran the details to the right route, hung on to the football. Little things can make a big difference.
Yeah, that's why they call it a game of inches, David. But I'll say this. If you're on offense, don't go on social media this week. It ain't going to be pretty after this performance. You've got to lock in. You got to take the week of practice very seriously and find those positives that you can build off, David, you're talking about.
It's really easy to get caught up in the emotion of a rivalry game. We did, and certainly this was a huge win.
Yeah, and you started, you circled it, you were ready for this team. This is the rivalry you put a lot of stock in all offseason. You're talking about this game in particular. You go out and get the dub. It's a relief because you definitely wanted this team.
And it's bragging rights for everybody, for the coaching staff, for the fans, but how about for the players as well? For another 365 days, you can talk about how you went out, you dominated, and you beat your rival.